Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about the pattern of crutch walking. Floor walking rules. Which are the rules that we should follow while walking with the crutches on the floor? First rule for non-weight bearing gait pattern, good first, either it could be a crutch or a limb. Second, partial weight bearing gait pattern, bad first, either it could be a crutch or a limb. Third one, full weight bearing gait pattern, bad first, either it could be a crutch or a limb. In crutches, for non-weight bearing gait pattern, patient stands with the triangular base. The affected side of the leg never carries the weight. As it is non-weight bearing gait, the patient with brace, POP, fractured limb, early stage of joint replacement, surgery, needs this type of non-weight bearing gait pattern. 3-point gait. In non-weight bearing gait pattern, good first, so an affected side crutch, then affected side crutch, than an affected leg. In early stage, the patient has to keep his unaffected leg behind the crutch line, is called as swing to gait. Once the patient mastered it can keep the leg beyond the crutch line, is called as swing through gait. In 2-point gait pattern for the crutches, unaffected and affected side crutch and then unaffected leg. Progression. In early stage, swing to gait, and in late stage, swing through gait. 4-point gait pattern or shadow walking. In this, affected leg comes in contact with the ground but not carrying weight on it. First one is affected side crutch, then unaffected side crutch, then unaffected leg, and then affected leg without weight bearing. Partial weight bearing gait. This is progression from shadow walking. Patient who are recovered from fracture, interfixation, joint replacement surgery and early stage from removal of POP are eligible to recommended for the partial weight bearing gait pattern. 4-point gait pattern. For partial weight bearing gait, there is a bad first, so affected side crutch, then unaffected side crutch, then affected leg and then unaffected leg. Progression. In early stage swing to and in late stage swing through. In 3-point gait pattern, both the crutches together, then affected leg and then unaffected leg. Progression. Early stage swing to and in late stage swing through. 2-point gait. In this we have two method. Method 1, affected and unaffected crutch with affected leg, then unaffected leg. Method 2, unaffected side crutch with affected leg and then affected crutch with unaffected leg. Full weight bearing gait. This is progression from the partial weight bearing. The walking pattern is same as that of the partial weight bearing walking. Stair activity rule. Good to heaven, bad to hell. Leg placed first while climbing up, crutch placed first while climbing down. Climbing up. For non-weight bearing gait pattern, 3-point. First one is unaffected leg, then affected crutch and then unaffected crutch. 2-point gait pattern. First unaffected leg, then affected and unaffected crutch. For partial weight bearing, 4-point gait pattern. First unaffected leg, then affected leg, then affected crutch, then unaffected crutch. 3-point gait pattern. First one unaffected leg, affected and unaffected crutch. Full weight bearing gait. It is same as that of the partial weight bearing. Climb down. First one is non-weight bearing. 3-point gait pattern. Unaffected side crutch, then affected side crutch, then unaffected leg. 2-point. Unaffected and affected side crutch and then unaffected leg. Partial weight bearing. 4-point gait pattern. First one is the affected crutch, then unaffected crutch, then affected leg and then unaffected leg. 3-point gait. Affected and unaffected crutch, then affected crutch and then unaffected leg. Full weight bearing is same as that of the partial weight bearing. Now for canes, there are two type of gait pattern, 3-point gait pattern and 2-point gait pattern. For 3-point gait pattern, cane, then affected leg, then unaffected leg. In 2-point, first one is the cane and the affected side leg and then unaffected side leg. Progression. In early stage swing to and in late stage swing through. Stair climbing technique. Climb up. 3-point gait pattern. First unaffected leg, then affected leg and then cane. 2-point gait. First unaffected leg, then affected leg and cane together. Climb down. 3-point gait pattern. First one is affected leg, then cane, then unaffected leg. 2-point gait, affected leg and cane together, and then unaffected leg. Walker or walking frame, for non-weight bearing, the walker is picked up and moved forward to the arm length. Weight is transferred through the upper extremity to the walker. The affected limb does not make contact with the floor and is held anterior to the patient body. The unaffected limb is then moved forward. The cycle is then repeated. For partial weight bearing, the patient picks up the walker and moves forward up to an arm length. The affected lower extremity is then moved forward and the body weight is transferred partially on this limb and partially through the upper extremity to the walker. The unaffected lower extremity is then moved forward and then the affected limb. The cycle is again repeated. Full weight bearing is same as that of the partial weight bearing.